My name is Elias Crespin, or Elias Crespin in Spanish. I'm from Caracas, Venezuela, where I was born and where I live and work right now. For the last few years, I've been working in research and artistic development of a series of pieces that I call electrokinetics, and which are motorized and computer controlled, generating an aerial metallic dance of elements. Being in front of a virtual cube of Jesus Soto, well-known artist from Venezuela from the 60s and 70s. And while looking at that, I thought, if this could move, it would be a great thing. 2 years after that, I started playing with motors in 2002, and in 2004, I finished my first piece after a lot of research and development at my studio at home. And then my first piece, Maya Electrocinética 1, or Electrokinetic Net 1, was finished. I submitted my project for a robotic art festival that was held in Dublin, Ireland, which is called ArtBots. And it's a robotic art show that gathers robots that make art, or robots that are considered art. I submitted my work, it was accepted, so I came to Dublin and I presented my work there. On the day of the opening, this elegant and mysterious young woman from London approached me and introduced herself. She's Diane Harris. And she said she had a museum project for London and that she liked very much my work and she wanted it to be part of her exhibition she was preparing for.
I first saw Elias's work at the ArtBots exhibition in Dublin, and the Mahler piece, when I first saw it, I absolutely fell in love with it. And it was exactly what I was looking for the life form show at Kinetica. I felt the piece captured what Kinetica was all about. And I thought that through Elias's work, he was showing ideas towards sort of planetary connections and sort of how things actually move through time and space. So it was very exciting to see his work, and I knew immediately I wanted him to participate at Kinetica.
I presented two pieces in this opening of Kinetica, which are tetra-aligned, or tetralineados in Spanish, and circuconcéntricos, or circuconcentrics. Each piece takes me around 2 months to construct, since I'm not into an industrialized production. I have to find the pieces, the parts, the resources. I like to plan and think what I want to do in the first term and use this finished structure to start to do the really artistic part with this, define the shapes and the movements and what happens when I look at it. Circuconcentrics, or circuconcéntricos, which is a set of 10 concentric iron rings that are suspended in 3 points, and from those 3 points I can control from the computer how they tilt in one direction or the other, and then I generate disintegration of the shape or a reintegration and an harmonic movements and play with the perception and surprise and beauty of shapes and crossing of lines that I can find by using this piece.
circucocentrico is, to me, that's much more cosmic, you know, where he's got these, the interplay of the sort of galactic, cosmic connections between the planets.
Tetra line is a set of line square wires or rods in a square shape that resemble somehow the skeleton of an accordion. I have no formal education in arts. I studied computer science. I love mathematics, the classes, and I applied many of the concepts I learned at home, playing with the computers and computer graphics, and that gave me a good base on computer graphics part of my work, which is how my pieces are technically controlled.
Tetralinios is much more mathematical, but also within the mathematics you get, to me it's evocative of nature. So you have the linear aspect, which is the squares, and it's all very linear, but Elias has managed to curve the line, which is actually sort of, you know, a quantum theory, isn't it? When you kind of, normally it's a straight line, but by curving it, becomes sort of takes you into the next dimension in a way. So I feel that Elias is actually curving reality, you know, through the line and the curve.
Thank you.
market's been fantastic. They have 20,000 people walk through this market every weekend. So, you know, it's been a real eye-opener for a new audience, really. So we've got Shoreditch, which is the biggest population of artists in the whole of Europe. I think there's about 30,000 artists, like in about 3 or 4 square miles. And we've got the City of London, like on the other side of our doorstep, which represents the technology and the business aspect of London. So we're really right, you know, on the crux of these two worlds. So the fact that Connetica is the first museum of Connetican electronic art in the UK, you know, we are really perfectly positioned.
The UK's first museum devoted entirely to kinetic and electronic art opens tomorrow in East London. Kinetica aims to provide an alternative to traditional art forms like painting and sculpture, and it showcases work from the 1920s to the present day. Our arts correspondent, Nicholas Glass, went along for a preview.
Kinetic art is all about movement and our childlike delight in seeing things move. Its proponents come from everywhere and every background. This work was created by a Venezuelan who trained in computers.
I learned how to move one motor from a computer, and then 2 motors, and then 8 motors. And now this system, this piece, is a system with 64 motors. After I, you know, do all this hard work on the technology, I try to forget about it and use it. Use it to do what I'm looking for, which is this artistic piece, what I call paint in the air. They were building the elevator. Because my pieces, all they do is move up and down, and the elevator moves up and down. So there were the technicians and engineers of the elevator there. We chatted a lot and we talked, and they asked me about my piece. The first question, in fact, was, what is that for? What's it used for? The night before the opening, one of them came and told me the more I look at it, the more I like it. So that's what it is about.